This month, two more businesses on St. Paul's Grand Avenue will be closing, leaving the historic street with up to a dozen vacancies. More than half of those are in buildings owned by an out-of-state landlord, which is drawing criticism tonight. Danny Spiewak has been looking into this, and he joins us now with more. Danny?
Well, Randy, according to Ramsey County property records, companies associated with a pension fund known as the State Teachers Retirement System of Ohio own at least four properties on Grand Avenue. With some of their buildings now going empty in St. Paul, the neighborhood is asking a lot of questions, but not getting a lot of answers.
Walk sign is on the cross, Grand.
Everybody in St. Paul knows Grand Avenue.
You know, Grand is a destination. It's St. Paul's Main Street.
But right? Grand Avenue Business Association President Chris Jensen faces a challenge in 2024 with two more businesses closing.
It's frustrating.
The closures include a Pottery Barn in the Grand Place building, which is already largely abandoned, and popular restaurant Salut, which is connected to a defunct Anthropology. The latest departures will leave two buildings basically empty, spanning two whole acres.
Doesn't look great, obviously. When we have vacancies like that, it is kind of an eyesore.
The two buildings are investment properties of the State Teachers Retirement System of Ohio, STRS for short, one of the nation's biggest public pension funds.
Their portfolio is so large that they don't have any idea the effect this is having on our community.
STRS Ohio holds more than $89 billion in investment assets, including more than $8 billion in real estate.
Fair to ask, or does the fund know that this property is sitting vacant?
Edward Siddell is an expert on pensions and former attorney for the Securities and Exchange Commission.
It's not unusual for these funds to invest broadly, to diversify their real estate investments.
But STRS has been all over the headlines in Ohio lately. The executive director is on leave after allegations of harassment, and teachers in the state have complained about the fund's operations and lack of transparency. In fact, Siddell was hired 2 years ago to audit STRS.
Lots of red flags, lots of turmoil. But this particular investing in real estate in your state would not be an initial concern.
Still, the Grand Avenue Business Association says it's been unable to communicate with STRS Ohio about the vacant storefronts.
We don't get a response.
However, STRS companies own two other buildings on Grand, which are mostly filled with tenants like Cafe Latte and Bread and Chocolate. And the avenue as a whole welcomed 11 new businesses last year.
These vacancies don't really reflect the current health of the avenue.
The Grand Avenue Business Association has also relaunched a working group with neighbors and the city council in St. Paul to try to figure out how to fill these vacant spaces on Grand. We would like to note, of course, that we have called and emailed STRS Ohio for comment, but they have not responded. Back to you.